evening, Dave. Tonight was a bullpen night, and the guys responded satisfactorily by allowing just one run in 9 innings. Your appreciation of the pitcher's performance in this important victory?
It would take me 32 minutes to go over all the pitchers today, because there's a whole lot of changes there. Fortunately, I didn't have to go to the mound to make too many, because then I'd have to have a special time to take care of my legs because of walking back and forth too much. So, but the pitchers competed right away from Tiedemann all the way through to Radke for the first time since he got his injury with the groin, and then Ademas, Nunez, Wilson, Cruz, Humbo, I mean, it would, Rodney. It's guys that have done it all year this year for us. They've been aggressive, they've competed, and the compliment goes to them, Eric Abreu and Alex Concepcion.
Dice que sí, que fue un partido donde hubo bastantes cambios de lanzadores. Tuvimos un día de bullpen, como bien decía Jordaniel, que era su pregunta. Y sí, dice que los pitchers estuvieron bastante agresivos, haciendo su trabajo como correspondía. Mencionó varios de los que estuvieron lanzando bastante bien. En general, todos, Jumbo, Steven Wilson, Radke, etc. Y que sí, que se siente bastante orgulloso del trabajo que hicieron los lanzadores esta noche para conseguir esta victoria. Tenemos a Luis Tomás Rae. Adelante.
Buenas noches. Mi pregunta es para Dave Yao, es sobre si, viendo el éxito que le dio hoy abrir con un opening, él tiene pensado seguir haciendo ese tipo de salida abriendo con un opening.
Considering this successful result tonight with using the bullpen, are you considering do it again?
You never know what goes on. I'm going to tell you, as a manager that enjoys running a bullpen, I'd much rather a starter go 9 innings and throw 91 pitches and give up 3 ground ball singles and not walk a person and strike out 5. But in the right situation, and we had a situation tonight that we had to do it, it's really fun to watch those guys go out and compete. Watch what Eric and Alex and those pitchers have done to get their pitches right and their delivery right and go and compete. So I'm not going to tell you. I know that Lowy's starting tomorrow, and we're not going to go to a bullpen day tomorrow. But yes, in this game, in the entire game, major leagues, minor leagues, independent ball, winter ball, there are openers. I mean, Lissay used Davey for 2 innings. So that's really kind of like an opener in a bullpen day. So you have a large bullpen, you do what you need to do, and today was a good one. But as a manager, I'd much rather have a guy throw a 9-inning shutout and 91 pitches.
Dice que incluso él como manager no sabe si vuelve a pasar. Que él particularmente disfruta mucho ver a esos lanzadores haciendo el trabajo que han hecho, sobre todo cuando un equipo tiene tanta profundidad en el bullpen como el Escogido, pues él disfruta ver el trabajo que hacen estos lanzadores, porque existe la modalidad de openers en liga independiente, grandes ligas, aquí en el invierno, pero que no puede asegurar que suceda otra vez. Mañana sabe que va Lowy a lanzar, pero que con el bullpen que tenemos es posible que se pueda dar esa situación en caso de que sea necesario, porque tenemos material suficiente para cubrir con nuestros lanzadores 9 entradas sin necesidad de un abridor. Tenemos una pregunta de Enrique Ramírez. Adelante.
Hi, Mr. Yaos. With these consecutive victories, do you feel satisfied with the team's achievement, or do you understand that you still have to improve?
A really good question. The two ways I answer that is the consecutive victory tonight is we were 1-0. Tomorrow we're going to try to go 1-0. We're going to do all that it takes to beat Estrellas here in Quisqueya and go 1-0. And right now, we were a better team than we were 24 hours ago. And at the end of the game tomorrow, we're going to be a better team than we are tonight. So your question is really good, but we're handling that question as a team and as a group. And there's no letdown on any pitch or any inning with this Escogido team.
La pregunta que hace es de las victorias consecutivas que tiene el equipo. Le dijo si tiene, si se siente satisfecho con el trabajo que está haciendo, si entiende que todavía podemos mejorar. Dice él que cada día tratamos de ser un mejor equipo, que hoy tratamos de ser mejor que ayer, mañana mejor que lo que hemos hecho hoy, pero que en cada partido, al final de cada partido, lo que cuenta es un 1-0, una victoria, 0 derrotas. Así es lo que trata de buscar cada noche. Y confía en el equipo que tiene, nunca baja la guardia y por eso cree que ha sido exitoso hasta el momento, pero que no piense en rachas, piense en el partido de cada noche que hay que ganar. Mañana estaremos en el Quisqueya otra vez y trataremos de buscar una victoria más. Alan Soriano, adelante.
Gracias, Michael. Saludos, dirigente. El Escogido, la ofensiva del Escogido ha estado tan demoledora que en 3 partidos, es decir, en 27 entradas, han anotado 17 carreras y el picheo ha permitido solo 7. La ofensiva ha sido encabezada regularmente por Joe Dunham. Este muchacho se ha adueñado del espectáculo últimamente. Y Franchi Cordero, que ha despertado con 2 jonrones y 4 remolcadas en los 2 últimos partidos. ¿Qué se ha trabajado especialmente con Franchi Cordero, que se ha visto ese despertar que se esperaba de él en los últimos partidos? Mr. Joss, congratulations for this victory. The offensive of Escogido has scored 17 runs and the pitching staff has allowed 7 runs. And Franchi Cordero have 2 home runs and 4 RBIs, and Joe Duna has been outstanding in the offensive of Escogido. What can you tell us from the progressive that has Franchi Cordero in these past 2 games?
Wow. That's, I don't think I should answer. You laid it out. I'm glad everybody got to hear that. I'm glad I got to hear that. I'm hoping Franchi Cordero and Joe Dunan heard that, because you nailed it. When players are playing really well, it's awesome to see. When they struggle, it's always good to see too, because they're learning, they're developing, so that they're really close to having a stretch like Franchi Cordero has, like Joe Dunan has had. And we expect our offense to work, to score runs, to give us an opportunity to win 2-1 games and 7-5 games, and sometimes 5-1 games. The only other thing is I never say that it's 2 guys, because tonight's biggest hit probably came from Sullivan when he hit the 2-run homer. And also, it might have come from Floreal getting a walk and getting to second on Rodriguez's ground ball, so that Franchi Cordero could come up rather than a double play, a ground ball double play. So those little things count just as much as someone going on a hot streak. Now, you love seeing guys who go on a hot streak, but so it's an entire team. And but I really liked your rundown. I was glad to hear it, because I probably would have had to try to read it in some stats, and you explained it really well.
Dice que le gusta escuchar las estadísticas que has mencionado. Se siente bastante halagado por el trabajo que han hecho tanto Dunan como Franchi Cordero. Pero que este no es un trabajo de 2 jugadores. Es el trabajo de todo el equipo, que se ha mantenido batallando y luchando en cada partido. En el caso de Franchi Cordero y de Joey Dunan, pues han podido mejorar. Han estado desarrollándose bastante bien en los partidos. Pero que en general es un trabajo de todo el conjunto, incluso un batazo sumamente importante de Sullivan, y también fue un jonrón de 2 carreras, o sea que todo el equipo hoy contribuyó a la victoria, y es lo que él más resalta de toda la actuación positiva que ha tenido el conjunto durante los últimos días. David Hernández, adelante.
Saludos, Dave. Buen partido. El trabajo de Rainer Cruz. Usted valoró el trabajo de todo el comité de picheo, pero específicamente quisiera escuchar de usted la valoración de ese relevo de Rainer Cruz, quien entró en un momento muy apremiante del partido.
He said you talk about a great performance of all pitchers tonight, but he wants to know specifically about Rainer Cruz because he was in the game in a very tough moment during the match.
Really, really good point. In the office before coming here, we made a point of that because we've gotten Rainer up a couple times in the last couple days. We hadn't used him, and he's been a tremendous professional in the clubhouse. He has a good history. I go back a long time with him, and he has treated everybody in the clubhouse, including myself, with the utmost respect, and hasn't always gotten the easiest roles. He's come in the middle of game, in middle of innings a bunch. He's gotten up and hasn't gotten in, and that's not easy for a reliever. Not easy for a reliever, no matter how old they are, how much they've done, what they've done. It's nicer to be in a role where when you get up, you go in a game. He doesn't get that. And tonight, he had to come in with Andres Nunez, who threw another really good outing, one plus innings. But he had to leave the game. He wasn't getting the job done in the second inning he had. And Rainer picked him up, which a lot of our guys have done, through the top part of the order. Got the two big outs to keep that lead for us so that we could give it to the leverage part of the bullpen late in Rodney and Adames and Wilson and Humbo. So very good point, and Reiner's a true pro. We all like him, and I have a lot of respect for him.
Ante todo, destaca las cualidades profesionales de Rainer Cruz. Dice que dentro del clubhouse se comporta como todo un profesional, que trata a todo el mundo con mucho respeto, incluyendo al propio Jaws, y que en los momentos en que él ha salido a lanzar ha hecho el trabajo, ha hecho un tremendo trabajo, y hoy no fue la excepción, dejando el terreno preparado para Jumbo Díaz y para Steven Wilson más adelante, pero que en especial siente un cariño por Cruz, por la historia que tiene, y sobre todo por el respeto que tiene para sus compañeros de equipo y para el propio dirigente, que también lo respeta muchísimo, e igual el equipo hacia él. Alfredo Villasmil, adelante.
Thank you very much for being here. I have two questions. First, you are 20 games, you have won 11, and there are only 10 games left. You are the only team who have won all the schedule right away. That's the first thing. So I know your attitude is tomorrow you're going to be 0-0 because you want to be 1-0, but it can be a lot of pressure because, you know, 10 games and four more games you are in. That's the first question. It's just a reflection I want to share with you. And the second one is Jumbo. I think that Jumbo has been one of the big guys in the team. So he's quite big, really, but in the other sense of the word. So what do you think about Jumbo as a main, one of the main pieces within the bullpen?
This one will be an easier question to answer for the man interpreting back there, because I won't answer, it won't be as long as yesterday. So, but I love your question. I love your question. Is first of all, I understand your question on records and how many games and stuff like that. We really, until you told me 11-9, I had no idea. And that's the honest truth. Somebody mentioned that we had a winning streak of some games. I have no idea that. When I get the stats in the morning or, you know, mid-afternoon sometimes, I look at it but it's not the first thing I think about. I look at it and I'm not oblivious to it, but it's not something I bring in. And we really do go start 0-0 every day. And that's the only way to play this game of baseball. And there's no pressure in this game of baseball. There's pressure when you're a dad and your son at 3 years old is running out for a baseball in the middle of the street. Because baseball is a game. I love it. I have passion for it. I want to win every day. But the most important thing is my kids grew up and they're grown up right now, and that's pressure. Some people that are probably listening right now might not know where their food's coming this weekend because they don't have a job or maybe they got COVID. That's pressure, okay? We'll move on. I'll get off my soapbox, I'm sorry. And Humbo's ready for the ball anytime. He's a competitor, he's a grown-up man. I trust him, the team trusts him. They want him on the mound. So that is a large ingredient of a true leverage bullpen person. And that's who Humbo is. Good questions.
Bueno, le hizo varias preguntas. Le hizo la pregunta sobre las rachas, sobre Jumbo Díaz y sobre si hay alguna presión por los partidos que restan por jugar en el campeonato. Dice primero que no hay ninguna presión, que la presión la tiene él cuando tiene unos hijos que tienen que ver crecer y está jugando béisbol. Presión siente cuando está lejos de su familia y está esta pandemia del COVID, pues ahí sí hay alguna presión, pero no jugar béisbol porque es el deporte que ama y que es lo que le gusta hacer. En el caso de Jumbo, dice que es un hombre bastante adulto, bastante maduro mentalmente, y que eso le da un ingrediente adicional al bullpen, contar con un hombre como él, un bullpen bastante fortalecido, bastante amplio que tiene el Escogido, y Jumbo Díaz con sus cualidades, pues fortalece ese cuerpo de lanzadores que tiene el conjunto. Y sobre las rachas, lo mismo, salimos a ganar cada partido, salimos a ganar y a buscar un 1-0 todas las noches. Si se dan las rachas, pues perfecto, pero cada partido lo hace único y es lo que tratamos de hacer siempre, buscar la victoria en cada uno de esos encuentros. Mr. Giles, what happened? I didn't see you at the end of the game. What happened?
I thought our coaching staff would do a really good job finishing the game. So I thought I'd go down in the runway and let them finish it off. They're a really good coaching staff, and they deserve that win today. They deserve every win today, that coaching staff. So I thought it would be good to let them do that. But thank you for your question. If those things happen in the game of baseball, it's not as fun when there's no crowd there because it makes it a lot more fun. But it was just a disagreement that we had, and we moved on. We're very respectful to each other, and maybe I was wrong, maybe he was wrong, and we'll see when he looks back at the video.
Dice ahí que hubo un pequeño malentendido, pero que finalmente el equipo de coaches pues pudo llevar el partido, lo hizo bastante bien, y que él confía en el trabajo que ellos están haciendo, y que aunque él no esté, ellos van a hacer un buen trabajo como lo hicieron esta noche. Tenemos una pregunta de Luis Miguel Sena. Adelante, Luis Miguel.
Saludos, David House. Un placer. Buenas noches. La pregunta mía es la siguiente. Mañana va a ser el debut Vladimir Guerrero Jr. También tienen a Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Tienen a Francis Cordero y tienen a Gregory Polanco. ¿Cómo se les designó para el día de mañana? ¿Qué turno lo van a poner a Vladimir Guerrero Jr.? ¿Si va a jugar la primera base o la tercera base? ¿Cómo será el proceso de line up para el día de mañana?
I got you. It's a good question. It's a question that's going all around in my mind right now. I'm hoping, because of the situation that I had with the umpire, my wife lets me back in the hotel room, because she told me I wasn't supposed to get thrown out all year, and I did. But it was a pleasant discussion with me and the umpire. And again, we've discussed it even before coming here with the coaching staff and some of the front office people. We'll get the analytics department putting some things together. And those players you mentioned will know the lineup before you do.
Dice que es una pregunta que le está pasando por la cabeza en este momento, no sabe qué va a pasar, pero prefiere concentrarse en la victoria de esta noche y ya mañana pues sabremos qué vamos a hacer. Y dice que va a tomar una decisión antes que lo que le corresponda hacer, pero que vamos a esperar a mañana qué sucede, si va a estar en el line-up, en qué posición, así que no se desesperen, chicos. Mañana sabremos dónde estará jugando Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Muchas gracias a todos ustedes. Mr. Yao, thank you very much for your time. It was my pleasure. Y gracias a todos y será hasta un próximo encuentro con los Leones del Escogido. Buenas noches.
¡Ruge!